Joshua Shrimp.
And what are you doing out here?
Shovel racing.
Have you done it before?
Yes, since I was about 7.
So how was it? Have you been up here every year?
Yes, almost every year, minus the last 2 years.
What do you like about it?
What's not to like? It's going down a hill with no brakes. I guess I like that it's crazy. I don't know. I've heard tips on tuning and stuff, but I guess it's all in how the shovel is. I don't know.
Did you polish that thing? Or?
No, I don't know. I didn't polish mine, but whatever works. Some people think it goes faster. Maybe it does. I don't know. Shovels.
What's your name?
Kayla.
Kayla? And how long have you been doing this?
Since 94.
And your shovel there, is that your pretty much everyday shovel?
Yeah.
What do you like about shovel racing?
It's fast and it's fun.
Pick it up.
It's pretty cool.
What would you compare it to other snow sports?
It's about as good as skiing. But, yeah. Pretty cool. Gotta try it sometime.
I don't know if he's quite gonna make it to the finish.
I'm gonna go like Kyle goes.
Well, he's gonna be back.
Just keep your feet up, kiddo, and keep them together, okay? Put your hands out, and you can steer that way. Just
abs of steel, man. You ready?
There you go. Bye.
Have fun.
Get back.
I think he's
scooting
forward.
Sit on the back of the shovel.
So you won't have to come up. I'll stay and find out what happened, though. Unless you want to come up and find out what happened. Yeah.
So, Gail, explain to the camera here, what exactly are you doing?
This time I want you to push off harder, okay? Jump up and down. Run in place. Come on, warm up. He's cold.
Gotta warm up.
Don't want those muscles to get stiff.
Put it in the snow and let it get cold. Don't.
Come back up and speed it on and go down the side. Okay.
4, 5, 4, 1.
Thank you. Next racer, Brianna Demoda, bib number 367.
Come on, Brianna.
3, 2, 1, go.
Go, Brianna!
My name is John Strader. I'm a longtime shovel racer, head of Team Shovelmeister. I'm from Albuquerque, New Mexico, but I was raised here shoveling since I was 13 here in Angel Fire, New Mexico.
So how long have you been racing?
I've been racing since I was 13, and it was probably back in 82, 81, somewhere around there.
So how long has this sport actually been going?
But the sport of actual shovel racing, as not as much a sport, but people riding shovels, has been going on for many, many years. All the way back to the movie It's a Wonderful Life, the first scene of that movie is kids riding down the hill on shovels. Now, even then, shovel racing was synonymous with danger, because what happens to the kids? They slide out onto the ice and they fall in. So, you know, shovel racing's been around a long, long time. People have actually ridden shovels down the loose tracks. That's one of our goals in the future, or something like that.
Yes.
Exactly. You get a stock shovel, grain scoop. They've got numbers here. You can get a 10, 12, or a 14. You cannot modify the shovel in any way. The only thing you can do to the shovel is to buff, polish, and wax the bottom. But other than that, it must retain all the qualities of a shovel, So you sit on it and you ride down the hill. The X Games picked us up for their first ever Winter Extreme Games, and we went on out with the modified shovels. I raced in that. My team shovelmeister brought four sleds, but we had a couple good crashes and some injuries, and afterwards ESPN declared that we were too extreme for the Extreme Games.
How is that ironic?
Sad, isn't it?
Yes.
Anything you want.
Anything you want.
Basically, most people cut the handle off, put this thing on the bottom, has to be underneath your butt, and then you build an incredible sled all around it.
Wow.
All right. Okay, now scoot back a little bit so you want your tail just like right on the end, but not hanging off. Okay, that's good, right there. Now you want to grip the handle with your knees. Grip real tight with your knees, lift your feet up, point them, point your toes, point your toes.
So your feet can't be on the snow, right?
No, you want to keep your feet up. It's like this, like a luge, and lean back into a position. And he can grip onto the side of the shovel like this, and this is the position he wants to stay in. Now, if he needs to steer, you just put out your hand like this. So if he starts to turn this way, you drag a hand like this, and that'll bring you back around to the front. Now, a lot of people who are just beginning put their hands out like this to the side. Go ahead. Just like this. And so that way they have a stability, and they can just sort of cruise down like this. And what happens if you start to lose control is you want to lay back in the corpse position. Lay all the way back. And that way it'll slow you down. The one thing you don't want to do here, sit up. The one thing you don't want to do is spin around backwards on the shovel. Because if you spin around backwards, the handle will dig in and pound you in the head.
Oh. Right. Whoa. Have you been pounded in the head, Sean?
Okay, all right, right there.
Woo!
All right, so what's your name? Look at the camera here and tell me what your name is.
Derek Adkins.
How long have you been shovel racing, Derek?
3 years.
3 years? What's the best place you've come in so far?
Really, I like the same type of shovel.
Third? Third?
Yeah, it does.
Third? So what's your secret of speed? Lean back and go fast. Do you have any special wax concoctions on the shovel today?
You have to ask for dad now.
Oh, your dad hooked up your shovel, huh? Who's your dad?
Don.
Is he a shovel racer?
Yeah. Thank you. Have a clear question.
3, 2, 1,
go. Right on
course. Yeah, Derek! Yeah!
My name's Pat Burgess, and I hope you can hear me. My voice is a little cracking up here, but I've been shovel racing. First time I did it was in 1973, and then we skipped a year, and I've done it just every year but two since then.
What keeps you coming back?
Well, it's a lot of fun. It's racing. Ask any racer why they come back, and they'll tell you it's an adrenaline thing, and it's just playing a lot of fun. And, of course, there's a challenge, too.
What's the most challenging part of it for you?
Production runs? It's probably not ever having to make a steering correction. If you can make a run in a good aero position without ever making a steering correction, you're gonna be in the money.
What happens when you correct?
Well, on one of these, you have to touch the snow, or in other words, it'd be a tiny braking movement to one side or the other, but a braking movement is just what it says. It's a braking movement, so you'll be slowing yourself ever so slightly.
Do many of your friends your age do this as well?
Well, yeah. This fellow over here does it, and there's another old timer from Angel Fire that's been doing it for a zillion, actually longer than I have, and there's a few of us.
You have friends that say, oh my God, I don't know why you do that.
Yeah, a lot of people, but I don't think they know.
What do they say? What do they say to you?
They say, why do you do something like that? Isn't it scary, et cetera? And I say, well, it's not really scary. It's just a whole lot of fun. If you ever were on a sled as a kid, it's real similar. I've won the modifieds three times. I finished second four times and third five times. But it's been a while since I've been in one of those three positions. I did race last year and got a fourth. And it's changed a lot over the years. A lot of people don't realize it, but when both production and modified started, they didn't have slope grooming and actually raced these things through moguls. You had to be able to steer. And frankly, I think maybe the guys that raced production back in the old days were better I know they were better at steering than we'll ever think of being. We're better at going just flat out. But over the years, it's evolved, and now it's a straight shot, and it's much faster than it ever was before.
Have you ever been injured racing?
Yeah. In 1985 was a big technological leap here in the modified shovel racing, and was the first year we had any serious accidents. Another guy I know flipped his and shattered a helmet and kind of hurt his shoulder. Later he found out he broke his collarbone. And then I flipped mine, and I walked away from it, but I thought, man, I'm not going to let that happen. So on my second run, I really hit the brakes, and unfortunately, I really flipped it, and I got the distinction of being the first one to get to go to Taos in an ambulance. And to make a long story short, I crushed my rib cage is what I did, and punctured a lung, and had to spend a few quality hours, or days rather, in the hospital. I came back the next year, yeah, and I got third place.
Well, what do you want me to say?
Well, how long have you been doing this?
All right. I did it 7 times yesterday for the first time in my life. When I go today, it'll be my 8th time. And my second run of the day, it'll be my 9th time. Problem competing with me. I'm lucky if I come down straight. Yesterday I came down doing 360s all the way down, but it was fun. People ask why I did it. Well, I just did it because it's there to do. And it's a great sport. And seeing some of those guys up there are professionals, but they wipe off their shovel. And they wax it, and they come down, they've got the farm. Me, when I come down, I make rooster tails all over everything. But it's a good sport, a lot of fun, and I don't think you can get hurt on it.
My name's Gail Boles. I'm a shovel racer. I've been shovel racing for 4 years now. I've won this event twice. I guess becoming the first person to win Speed Modified and this event, the Production Shovel. It's a heck of a gas. Once you do it, you're in there for life, I think. It's an addicting sport that is really unique in the fact that there's not a whole lot of people that are a part of this group of racers and this event or anything that's as unique as this. But anyways, anybody can do it. You don't have to be a rich man or a rich man's kid. You can get into this sport just with a simple grain scoop. If you can't afford one, it'll be provided when you pay your entry fee. It's a whole lot of fun. There's different techniques, and people laugh at certain wax or whatever. You know, car wax was used for a while. A lot of people use ski wax now. There's been talk of using a canned ham, so who knows? You laugh at a canned ham, but if it beats you, then you ain't laughing anymore. So,
so what do you think the thrill of shovel racing is?
Well, you're right on the ground. There's no motor. It's quiet. And most people freak out when you tell them, how fast do you go? 65. 65 on a shovel, which is, I think, pretty impressive. There ain't no telling how fast people are going to go from here on out. You know, there's talk of Guinness Book of World Records maybe coming out and filming some of us going for a speed record on one of these, and who knows how fast that's going to be, but we'll have to get some heavier gear on for that.
Tell us a little bit about your modified career.
I started off in what's called a light modified. There's a lot more of those here this year. They're kind of crazy in the fact that you don't have a roll cage or a harness or anything like that. You're just on top of it. If you crash, you just come out of it. They're the cheapest ones to build. I mean, my first one that I raced in was a piece of quarter-inch steel screwed into two skis, and you just go. I mean, $50. Now it's kind of progressed. My last craft, I spent probably $2,000 in materials. That doesn't even count all the man hours that we put into it. So, but you never know. I mean, sometimes one of these $50 machines, that first year I did it, after the first run, I was in third place, beating out these guys that had spent thousands of dollars, and they were a little PO'd that this little cheap piece of junk had beaten their expensive machines. But you know, that's part of it. You know, who goes the fastest? It doesn't matter how much it costs. It's just, that's the bottom line. Who goes the fastest is what takes home the cheese. So, I think the sport is going to be growing real fast. As soon as we get some of these drag racers, sprint car, you know, somebody to get them to cross over from motorsports to this, you know, those guys, the gearheads, they aren't interested in something that they're going to have to, like, you know, like learn how to ski or ice skate. They don't care. They want something that, you know, has a chassis and it's going to go fast. And, I mean, Don Adkins won the X Games. The guy's never skied a day in his life, but he understands speed. You know, he drives dragsters, builds dragsters, he builds stock cars. And that's basically one thing about the speed modified. You got to have some big cojones if you want to win. But anyways, sport's growing. Come on out.
Yep.
Hi, my name is Lauren Pavlo, and I'm 29 years old, and this is my second year racing at the shovel races, but I've been coming for many, many years, and I like shovel racing because it's exciting, and you can go fast, and it's just a lot of fun, and people cheer for you, and, you know.
You ready to go fast now?
I want to go fast. I want to go really fast.
And what do you think your secret of speed is?
My secret, well, is going straight. My shovel, I've got wax on my shovel. This really special ski wax, it's like a secret, but I'm going to go really fast if I go straight. If I don't go straight, then I'm not going to go very fast, so, you know.
All right.
And I want to beat Kim, the world champion of the world.
Well, good luck.
Thanks.
Go ahead and state your name and where you're from.
Hi, I'm Erin Holmes. I'm from Los Angeles, California. This is my first shovel race. I've been down the hill about 1.5 times, I guess, counting my little practice runs here.
How'd you feel going down?
I was scared and amused the first time because it's hilarious. But after I got some techniques down, it was really fun.
But you're not a novice to extreme sports, correct?
No, I do street luge. Street luge was my 98 New Year's resolution. And so I've been doing it for about a year. And this was my 99th. New Year's resolution.
You said you're going to come shovel race for the New Year's resolution?
Exactly. All and right. Here I sit, so or stand.
All right, what's your secret of speed today?
I have absolute faith that I'll make it to the bottom of the hill really fast. And I'm just going on faith today.
So now it's further up the hill.
There she goes, make it! I said, make it.
Ready?
You got it.
3, 2, 1, go.
Go, Lauren!
Yeah!
Yeah! Oh, nice!
All right, pull your hands in, Lauren. Pull them in now. Pull them in.
All right, Aaron. Good luck.
Come on, Aaron.
Ow, baby!
Next.
Take these boys to school.
Perfect conditions, too.
Right here. You got it. You got the window.
Ready?
Bust it, bust it.
3, 2, 1.
Paddle out, paddle out.
Go, girl, paddle. Go.
All right, lean back, lean back, lean back.
There you go.
Hands up.
Hands up.
You're up and then Sharon.
3, 2, 1, go.
Hey, Kim. There's a former world champion right there. She is fast. Oh, the other one. Sorry. Oh, she's fast. Yeah.
Oh, Kelly.
Well, she didn't race that. Yeah. She just had a baby.
Yeah, Kelly, yeah. Oh, Kelly Hockables. And then just get in your form and back. Keep your hands right here. And then just touch, touch, touch.
Go, Lauren. It's school time, baby.
Just have fun. Speed deep, shovel. You got it.
Take him to class.
Keep your knees gripped so you don't slide up.
Oh my God.
1, go.
Hit it, Lauren, go.
There you go, Lauren.
All right.
Yeah.
All right, Jimmy. Speed up to speed it. And that's way too much. Just like
try to get a real good push off the start.
Next up, Kim Romero. Ready, Kim?
Just a good push off and then
3, 2, 1, go.
Come on, Kim!
All right, there we go. There we go. Pull your hands in! Oh, oh, oh! Again. Oh, grip it with your knees.
Clear course.
Even go.
Ready?
Just do one shove off and then just get in your position.
1, go.
Go!
Pull it!
Go, 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 go! Go, 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 go.
Dog. What? Go!
Stand by.
His hands all taped up.
Here comes John, right down the middle. Looking good. I didn't think he had it in him. Look at this. He's moving. John Boy, yeah.
First modified, so we want to make sure we got that fixed.
What's coming, Margie?
I'm not even on.
Okay.
Yeah. John?
Yeah.
We're recording.
I don't know if it's Cory. Well, whoever it is, they're not slowing down. Looks like dog. It's in Thor's hammer. Nice. Beautiful.
Got him.
Cory Humphrey in his test run. Thor's hammer coming down the mountain. Nice! That's Danny Bureau, street loser extraordinaire in his light modified. Alright, fire and ice on some ridiculous chopped off skis, but having a good run, very straight, very smooth, looking good. Oh, right next to Rob's got a good shot, here comes the break. Nice.
Man, that thing stopped quick.
How fast was that?
72.
You had it on the thing? 72 miles an hour for the test run. That looks like the guy from Dumber Racing, Los Alamos. It's a really simple, very simple light modified craft. Not a bad little test run. Eric Oliver in the green machine, coming down, looking nice. Oh yeah. Nice, Eric. James, whoa, he's squirrely. He's squirrely. He's definitely squirrely. He doesn't have any real skis on there. It's just these homemade. Oh, nice! Nice! Yeah! That's the way to do it, Mike! Yeah, brother! Tejas! The backdraft. Coming down. It's going fast. Nice brakes. It stops! A Villalobos sled that stops! My god, man! Alright, there's pieces of the Villalobos sled all over. Everyone's peeking underneath. I wonder if that brake sheared off again. It's not looking good for the boys. I don't know what's going on. We'll have to find out what's happening. Looking like we've definitely got some sort of braking problems. Something is sheared off, but you can see the shovel underneath the snow sticking out beautifully. But that thing always has problems with the brakes. Some kind of issues going on. So we're having a little hold here.
Kim Clark, I'm the director of resort operations.
So Kim, what kind of safety precautions do you take? How dangerous are these modified racers?
They're very, very safe. First off, every sled goes through an inspection before it's ever brought up on the hill. We check for two different kinds of brakes, a primary brake and then their emergency brake, the stop brake. Secondly, after they go through the inspection, we bring every sled up on the hill and let them do an on-hill test run in which they have to test both brakes and make sure that they work. If there's any failure or any concern about it at that point, we make them go back and re-inspect and we'll do another test run at that point.
How long has this race been going on here?
I believe this is the 26th year.
And what's the most serious accident there's been at this?
That's probably something I can't get into, but there has been a couple of fairly serious accidents, but overall it's been very, very safe.
Berms and stuff like that, maybe.
Yeah, what we do is we blow snow in the area here. We build up the berms. The inside berm, the one on the right, is a little bit higher towards the bleachers. We keep both berms as vertical as we can so that if a sled should hit it, it bounces the sled back in. There's no chance of it arcing and going up on top. At the very bottom where all the banners are, you can see is a catch net. It's on 2 8-inch steel posts that are sunk 5 feet into the ground. It's tensioned with rods and come along so that it remains a constant tension. The sled, if their brakes should fail, will go into that as the first point of contact. Behind that then is a snowbank that currently is about 14 to 15 feet high and about 40 feet thick as a final stopping point. Nothing will get by that.
At the end of the day here, what do you hope to remember about this year's modified race?
That we have approximately 40 safe, perfect runs, and one of the things we're looking for on this nice day is to maybe break the records, go for new top-end speed and new ET down the course. The course itself is, or the race itself is judged on the fastest elapsed time from point to point.
Last question here.
Okay.
So what are the top speeds right now, and who do you think is out there that might break those top speeds?
There's several of the competitors out there this year that I think have a good shot at the top speed. I believe the top speed is approaching 80 miles an hour with the modifieds. Gail Boles, the three-time defending champion, has a good shot at that. Don Adkins, we've got a couple of new runners in there this year that look very promising. If everyone gets their wax right with the sun and everything today, I would say just about every sled out here has got a shot at it today. Pretty tight.
So what's your name and tell me the name of your sled?
Name's Robert Anthony and the sled is Terminator.
And what do you expect to do here today?
Hopefully win.
Have you won before?
I haven't, but Kermit has. You've taken second. Kermit's taken second. Third. A few places.
It's awfully cramped in there. Is this going to help you go down fast here?
Yeah, the more aerodynamic the better. Next year we plan on building a sled even tighter.
How long has this sled been around?
This sled's been around 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
3 years.
Jesus Christ, was a motorcycle.
What's your secret for speed?
Wax. Mm-hmm. Speed wax. Good skis and good ski wax.
I'm a media dog.
Okay, you're the you designed and built this. Your name?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Kermit. Kermit Brown. That's why I call this the Kerminator. I built a couple of these. This is my third one, actually. My first one was a motorcycle on skis. It actually was a pretty neat skiing machine. I could run gates with it if I had to.
Now, how do you mean a motorcycle without an engine and just?
Right. It's just a motorcycle chassis. Set up with a suspension system in the back, so the rear skis would edge when you lean the bike. The front ski would edge, and plus have the telescope front end on it, you know, from the motorcycle. And it had a ski boot in the front full of concrete to hold it down. Yeah.
Now, what's different about this machine, or why did you change from the motorcycle?
Well, it's you're sitting up on top of it. There's no aerodynamics about it at all.
So this is.
Yeah, I decided to get in one because I laid that motorcycle down 1 year doing about 74 miles an hour right in front of a bunch of cameras. It was a pretty good hit.
Recording it on film.
Yeah.
So you went to this more aero design, and this is the second year?
Yeah, this is the second one I've actually got inside of. he always know how to build the next one. I'm kind of an old junkyard fanatic. You know, this thing has snowmobile parts in it. There's parts out of a motorboat in here. I've got rototiller stuff going on in the back. It's got ski lift tower parts, bed rails. There's some latches off of a Chevy pickup tailgate in there. And it's add them all together and they actually work. And it doesn't cost you an arm and a leg to put it together.
How does he steer?
Set of handlebars right here. Watch your feet. Set of handlebars right here, just like a car steering. Pick it up a little bit. Been sitting in one place too long. Basically, kind of like a motorcycle, actually. And this is a handbrake here going on. It's got a set of foot brakes in here that activate a primary system. And this drops a secondary system, this handle here. And then we got an ejection button that throws a piano out the back, you know, on a logging chain. Makes a little racket, but it's kind of musical. Other than that, this sled is pretty much basic.
Oh yeah, this could be juicy.
Whatever possessed you to get on the scoop of a shovel and come down this mountain?
We came up Thursday. My son says, let's try shoveling. I says, what's that? So he says, you get this and slide. I says, okay, let's go.
Well, I tell you, there's a lot of folks over in the crowd and on both sides, a lot younger than you, that would never do this. So,
right.
So how high you want to go up there? We're going to do just a little camera shot here for some of the crews. You want to start here or you want to go a little higher?
Oh, this is good. I would like to start there, but I'm so stiff and sore that I'd better start here.
That sounds good to me. Well, I tell you, that's it. That was quite a run. The Ames Shovel Company gave Friday this scoop shovel. Okay, he's got that. You want to give him a little push start here? All right, let's bring him that. Get that push start. Get inside. Have it down there. There he goes, our octogenarian shovel racing senior.
See that big one?
Yeah, I saw one of them.
Yeah, they've had some interesting ones.
I don't know.
Where's this one?
No. Survived.
Keep it up.
Another break that releases the back one. Just switch.
And what speed is this one?
How does this one steer?
Is it hard to build?
Basically, the trucks are still inside.
We get next year.
Yeah. This one's got shocks and everything too.
Yeah. See, in my mind, I've been building these things in my head, but I've never seen them yet.
Because of all the components that are under it, that you have a lot of cross members and channels.
I've seen that, man. And of course, KZR 94 Rock, every year, baby. We're happy to have them. I think this is about your fourth trip up here, I guess, fourth or fifth? I can't remember.
Fourth?
Well, I don't know, but you come up. Have you been here 10 times? Okay.
Come on, man.
Are you sure you're getting out of your hotel room all the time?
Give me a little credit at least.
Okay.
Strain yourself now, guys.
Oh. Got more stuff there to hold me. Where did you want my skis?
Right about here.
Right here?
You got tons of small shovels.
This is really rough.
Like a loop. Whoa.
Okay, Odin's fire. Gail Boles at the top of the course. He's on course. This should be a fast run. He's got a great line, taking it right down the center of the mountain. Gail Boles, former world champion, he's got a great line. This could be the best time of the day. He looks fast. He's got a line right down the center. He's close to it. And he brings it to a stop. He was kissing the wall. Give him a big hand. That was a 77 miles an hour. That's a new leader. 77 miles an hour. Gail Boles, 13.2. So not only did he have the fastest miles per hour, he had the fastest elapsed time from top to bottom.
Gail Boles just got disqualified. He had his shovel underneath there bungeed up. So it's an illegal run. He's disqualified on the first run.
Yikes.
They spaced it, definitely.
You don't get to go at all again, or what?
That's
what
I do. Like,
run last.
I'll go right away now.
Yes, that's the thing. You're last.
Run last.
Fire nice. Keep your eyes out. Fire nice.
So, the disqualification of...
And he's not in charge of Bungee.
World Champion Gail Boles, do you think that this was the fault of the crew as a whole, or
yes,
specific members?
Yes, I think
members?
There was eight guys up there, and they should have reacted.
Okay, so do you think that Gail's going to be able to pull it out on the second run?
My God, I hope so.
Okay.
I think if he grabs his crotch hard enough and he wore his cup, he's okay.
Okay, yeah, because sometimes you just got to have the balls to shovel race.
It's all, I'm going for the cup.
That's the man on the street opinion.
That was not me.
No,
that was not me. That was Carol Dobos.
Know how to fold them.
Carol Dobos. That was Carol Dobos.
Hey, like it could be the second run because, as you know, Gail Boles DQ'd on his first run. That's just probably an oversight that he forgot to drop his shovel. But do you like your chances in that last spot?
They're looking pretty good right now.
Well, I know that when you come down, it'll be a run that we'll all want to see. Do you think anybody's going to get, we got 75 miles an hour, 77. You think anybody's going to get to 80?
Depends on the radar guy up there, if he's steady.
Okay. It's all a technical problem then. Well, anyway, now...
Fire and ice.
Ready? 3, 2, 1, go.
he had some steering problems and overcorrected, which is something
I'm good on the ground.
When these things go, we're warning you, you need to get out of the way. But that first hit, it launches him in the air.
Here comes
Team Pro. Waiting for word if he's okay in there. We don't know. All right, thumbs up, he's okay. It was, I guess, fortunate he was going to flip it, Robin, that he flipped it at a slower speed, but it was still fairly spectacular.
Oh, absolutely. Once they get upside down, that's not the way they're designed to be in there. Up in the air pretty high, any more miles per hour if it happened down here closer to the finish line, it would have been quite a wreck.
Get to Angel Fire, New Mexico, but he's got a great line right down the center of the course. He's low to the ground, barely touching the steering. He looks fast for a first-year pilot. He's coming down to the bottom and crosses the finish line. Can he bring it to a stop? He's trying. A little bit, she's got a nice line down the middle of the course.
She's steering it down. You go, girl.
Nice run. She brings it to a stop. One of the few women pilots. Give her a big hand. Amy Sanchez. Nice run.
Good rookie ride.
Seventy miles an hour. So, hey, that's not bad for a first timer.
That's my idea of a fast woman.
You know, it'd be interesting to get her back up here. I know that a lot of people, after their first run, would have some pretty insightful things to say to us
once
here.
Once you're finished screaming and fogging up your face mask, yeah. There's lots of interesting things come out of your mouth.
Okay, she gets out and she's happy about it. She gives her crew a hug. Right. She is having a great time here.
She's stoked.
Angel Fest, she's stoked. She said, boy, that was fun.
Yeah, she's got big feet, that girl.
I'm not sure if you noticed, we haven't said this, but the one thing that gets all these guys crazy, I mean, there's an old saying, the motto of the shovel racers, faster, 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 till the thrill of speed overcomes the fear of death. And Amy has embraced that thrill and is probably sorry that she's going to let her buddy come down in the second run, Robin.
Who says she's going to? She may just stay in there.
Line. He's got those wide track skis. He's got a pretty good line coming down through the finish line. Very fast, I'd say. He can bring it to a stop.
Nice brakes.
Hey! Of course,
How many years have you been coming to the snow races?
Top of the mountain is going to be Eric Oliver.
One. All right, we got a newcomer. So what do you think so far?
I saw a nice crash. Here's third.
You think the second set of runs are going to be even more intense and exciting? Faster. Is faster better?
They were lucky I ripped my leg this year. I would have smoked everybody.
All right. So a champion in the making, denied from his dream. More later.
Tell me about this sled of yours.
Well, this sled's been down the mountain, I think about 15 different times. Took 3 bronze medals at the X Games with it. We've took 3rd here before. And it's a good machine. It's solid Sears. It's good, it's fast.
What's your secret for speed?
Secret to speed, aerodynamics, balance on your skis, and good wax.
What type?
Can't
good
say.
Wax do people use?
Yeah, can't. Whole? That's an ancient Chinese secret.
You're not going to tell me what type of wax?
No.
Does everybody use a different wax? I mean, is wax, the different type of wax you use big up there?
It makes a big difference, you know, that and good skis, you know, make a big difference. It's just such a combination of so many different things that it's really tough to try to get every one of them, you know. But once you get them all in sync, you get to fly. And that's what it's all about.
What's this made of?
It's got a chromoly cage. All the roll cage is chromoly. All the body is styrofoam. This has about 1 foot of styrofoam in front, and it's made to impact and explode out in case I hit the net, which we've done that before. It's got full suspension on front and back. Take out all the bumps and the humps. And gosh, just a lot of padding and a lot of luck.
Why do you need the padding and why do you need the luck?
Padding's sure keeps you from getting bruised up and being so sore the next day in case you do wipe out. And luck is, it's about the most iffy sport I've ever seen going down that mountain 75 miles an hour because anything can go wrong.
You say it has happened before.
Oh, yeah.
Gone wrong.
Well, I've been down the mountain 33 times total, and I've crashed 3. I hit once and hit a wall and went end over end. Next year I caught an edge and went to the other wall and rolled along that wall. And then 1 year I had total brake failure and took the net at 73 miles an hour.
72? How would you characterize your luck?
3 out of 33 is not bad, so I guess I'm on a roll.
72 miles an hour, but he kept going. He didn't stop, that's why. 15.111. Did you say that was the fastest? Jeez, this dude got whaled on. Hope he's okay.
Right there. Took him a minute to get him out, but he's okay. All right.
So far, let's see if he can knock him off. Great run through the finish line.
Big save! Go!
Okay, he's bringing it back under. Ball. Oh, nice run stop.
Time.
Well, you're not going to put that one in, are you? This is supposed to be the short ones?
Yeah.
Brings it back into the center. Thor's hammer across the finish line. Can he bring it to him? Thor's hammer across the finish line. Can he bring it to a stop? Yes.
3.725
was his time.
Yeah.
Breaks too early. Let's see what he's got going. He's going to cross the... He did it again. That has to be a mechanical malfunction where he compresses. He is going to see what he's got going. He's going to cross the...
Disqualification of the first round of Gail Boles. Odin's Fire's crew, do you think they're at fault?
No.
So what do you think the problem was? Did somebody just not do their job, or?
I
think it was an oversight. Too much prep.
Too much prep. All right. So maybe a little too concerned with the minute details. All right. Gail, we're pulling for you, man. Do it on the second one.
helmet on first, right? Because you have to put it between here and strap in. Oh. Okay, okay.
You
have to do that strap too.
Yeah, we do.
Can you do it with your gloves on? Or do you have to take them off?
Well, I'll have him do it.
Oh, okay. You go for it. You go for it, Brian. Go for the crotch
stuff. That's not it. Good morning.
Comes through the finish line. 13.195. Let's get the miles per hour. Up there, they're going to try to knock him off, and two machines that represent between them about four world championships.
Okay, give me the beer. Woman on the street who we don't know. Do you think that the addition of the shuffle on this Gale's second run, do you think that that would have had anything to do with the 1 mile an hour loss that he experienced this run?
Straighten out your goatee before you speak, though. No.
Okay, so you just think that maybe the course is getting a little bit melty, slower. A little bit slower. Okay.
The experts say that.
Okay. I think it was the
man on the
large hole created by the.
It was rougher, you see, and he's got to absorb all that, you know, up and down, you know.
Yeah.
And it takes it all out, man.
Okay.
Know?
All right. Yeah. So you're thinking that perhaps it's just the normal course of nature that could be the cause of Gale's loss of a mile per hour.
It could be something like that. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Gale Boles.
currently in second place. How's it going, Gail? What happened?
We got rushed to the top and didn't get the bungee down. My buddy Butch was all pissed because the guy was...
The bungee for what?
He was holding the shovel up. And we didn't see it. And I guess the guy who lodged the complaint was standing right there and didn't say anything to us. Wait for us to run and then lodge his complaint. I'd have told somebody if I'd have seen him out there. So.
But how was that first run? Fastest run of the day? Fastest run of the day. What was your miles?
Well, if his shovel was down, it would have been a mile an hour slower. No way. I was rocketing. I think I even went faster than 77. I mean, 1 mile an hour slower in my second, no way. I can tell the difference in speed. That first one was...
So whose race do you think it is right now?
I said there was three sleds when we started. Mine, Corey's, and Don's. So, anybody's... Those two guys.
Shit.
Okay, wait, I want this bleacher to give it up for shovel racing. Come on. Chris, get the crowd pumped.
Give it
up for shovel racing.
Victory,
buddy. Yeah.
Got a great line right down through the center of the course. Beautiful run for Don Adkins. Rocketing across the finish line. That looks like the fastest run of the day.
Thank you.
All right, this is Raquel again, another man in the street. Okay, Gail, you know, a day filled with many mishaps. What do you see the problem? We were talking about the checklist that was interrupted. No, Butch and I were talking about the checklist that was interrupted. Do you think that that may have played a part?
They kind of have inspected stuff in the past years. There's two things, under 500 pounds and if the shovel touches. And there's people up there that were watching me start with that, you know, and they weren't going to say anything. They just wanted to disqualify me as soon as they started. You know, like somebody could have said something. Nobody wanted to. I know who would have won this race, but, you know, I guess you can't win them all, but I sure feel like I had this one in the bag.
Well, comments from Gail Boles, the world champion. Me. What was the problem with Gail's run being DQ'd? What's going on with that? What's happening?
I just say if there are going to be rules and officials and it's going to be called, it ought to be called from the top. I mean, they shouldn't be allowed to come down if they're going to be disqualified.
Yes.
Disqualified at the top.
That's right.
Just like they penalize at the bottom if they hit the net.
Right. So are we thinking that there may be some type of conspiracy?
No.
Okay. All right. Good. Good. Okay.
No way.
That was Mr. Boles. He is an authority on this matter, and I think we've all learned a little something today. All right, Butch.
Bummer.
Up at the top, what happened?
You don't want to know.
Lay it on me.
No, you don't want to know.
The camera public
I'm drinking
wants
them
to
with
know.
Both hands. That's what happened.
Raquel. Two drinks for Butch. Because Butch, he knows shovel racing.
I know what happened.
Tell us what happened, Butch. No. Apparently there was a little bit of a problem with the checklist.
We were screaming at the legends last night outside.
Lay it on me. The public wants to know.
Thank you, Carol.
The winner of the Modified Championships, Don Adkins. Don, how do you feel?
Good.
Good. So tell me about that last run.
It was rough.
It was rough?
Bouncing all over the place.
Did you know
but
you had it?
It was fast. It was fast.
Did you know you had it or were you worried a little?
No, I figured I didn't. I
really?
Third place.
Third place. So how's it feel? You've had 2 second places here at Angel Fire and now you're the champion.
It's time to let somebody else drive.
So what are you going to do now after you drink? You're going to go get drunk, aren't we?
No, I think that's the next thing.
So
that's priority.
What was your secret this year, Don?
Little wax action.
Little wax action? You
yeah.
got the secret stash?
Follow his tracks down.
That's it.
So Cory, what do you think? Another third place. Not too shabby.
It adds up.
It adds up.
In a winter with one of the worst snowpacks on record, many skiers and snowboarders are wondering where they're going to go to find the snow. Many ski areas have lifts just like this one that are not in operation because they don't have enough snow to get the skiers to the top of the mountain. But the skiers and the snowboarders are not the only people affected by this horrible ski season. For the first time in 30 years, the snow shovel races in Angel Fire have been canceled. The World Championship Shovel Races are held at Angel Fire in February each year. Many racers come from around the country to race in this unique event.
These modified shovel racers spend thousands of dollars and months of work on their machines. Sean Hughes of Edgewood, New Mexico, wrecked his sled at last year's race and has been waiting all year for his chance at redemption. He's upset about Angel Fire's decision to cancel this year's race.
And they cancel it on the last minute, and it's basically heartbreaking. And but you got to suck it up and just hope that we can do more next year and do just as good, maybe better.
Butch Johansson, owner of Edgewood Equipment, has been building modified shovels of several types for over 3 years. He has spent the past 5 months working on different types of sleds for this year's race. He too is affected by Angel Fire's decision to cancel the event.
Oh, I'm sure it's going to be a damaging blow. I mean, we got one race right now, and they cancel it, and we're waiting another year. You know, we got people from all across the country, built a lot of sleds, put a lot of time, effort, money into it. And, you know, in years past, I don't think Angel Fire's ever had 20 sleds. It was over 30. We're going to be there this year. I just don't see it as being a good thing, that, you know, canceling a race like that.
A spokesperson at Angel Fire said despite recent snowfall, the event has been postponed until February of 2001.
For Campus Reports at Sandia Peak Ski Area, I'm John Strader.